Hey, what's up, science fans? Jackson here from Science Museum, Oklahoma. What would it take to build a water-powered rocket at your house? Let's take a look. All right, so let's go ahead and build the rocket portion of our project. Now, I have some things that I found lying around my house, like some foam board, some 2 liters, an X-Acto knife, and a ruler. Let's go ahead and start by taking our other 2 liter and cutting this middle piece of plastic right here. All right, so once you've got this piece of plastic cut out, go ahead and set it aside. Now, I've had our glue gun heating up for a while. Go ahead and take that piece of plastic that you set aside, put it in front of you like this. Take your other rocket, put it on like this, and glue gun into place. So there we have it. There is the base fuel tank for our rocket. Let's go ahead and set this part aside and start on the fins. Now the fins are just going to be made out of this light foam board that I picked up at Walmart a while back and am just now having use for it. So go ahead and set this down. And this is where the speed square is going to come into play because we want really nice sharp edges on our fins for the most aerodynamic performance. So go ahead and take your speed square and a marker and make a mark just like that. Now I'm using an X-Acto knife. You can use scissors. I just find that X-Acto knives give me the more perfect cut and are just a little bit faster. All right, so now this is gonna be just a little bit too big to go on our rocket, so we're gonna wanna cut these down in half. All right, go ahead and do this process one more time. All right, so we've got the fins made. Now we need somehow to attach them to the rocket. Now we could just try our luck at gluing the fins directly to the rocket to save time, but I want to put something as just a secondary support. So I do have some of this foam board left over. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut a few strips of it to glue the fin to, and then glue that whole thing to the rocket. All right, so now we've got our fins and our strips cut out. Let's go ahead and attach them together and put them on the rocket. So go ahead and take one of your strips and one of your fins and just glue it onto the strip just like so. Doesn't need a lot of hot glue, just enough to hold it on and support it. Once it dries, it'll be good to put on the rocket. Let's go ahead and do this 3 more times. All right, so once you have all the fins and all the strips attached, you're ready to go ahead and put them on the rocket. Now, like I said, this made 4 fins and we're only going to need 3 of them. So go ahead and set one of them aside for just an extra. Take one of the ones that you're gonna use and put it on top of the rocket. All right, so once you've glued the fin on the rocket, do this 2 more times, making sure to space the fins out so that they are evenly distributed around the rocket. All right, so once you have all the fins on your rocket, let's go ahead and take this outside for a paint job. And while this dries, we'll get started on the base of the rocket. All right, so now that we have the rocket built, we need something to launch the rocket off of. So let's go ahead and build a launch pad. I found some materials lying around in my garage, like some 2x4s, some brackets, and this old piece of garden wire. Now, it's gonna take me about 20 minutes to build. So to spare you the time, I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward through the build process. Let's get started. So now we have our base completed. Let's go ahead and put it out on the launch pad. All right, so now that we've got the base built, we need to take a look at how we're going to fuel the rocket. So I've got here some water and dish soap. Dish soap is actually going to make a perfect solute for our jet fuel because what it's going to do is it's going to lower the density of the expelled rocket fuel, but it's also going to create this thick foam, which is going to increase the thrust capacity. So our rocket is actually going to be mostly dish soap. It's going to be about a 2-to-3 ratio, 2 parts water to 3 parts dish soap. All right, so now that we've got our dish soap, we're going to go ahead and put in our water. All right, we've got our water, our dish soap. Let's go ahead and add our cork and let's take this out to the launch pad.
All right, so now that we've got our rocket fueled and locked in position, let's go ahead and increase the pressure and start the launch sequence. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, so after a successful launch, we went back and looked at the video and I realized that you couldn't really see how high up the rocket went. It went probably about 100 to 150 feet in the air, which is pretty impressive. And I really do think that it's because of that Dawn dish soap. I wonder what would happen if we used another solute like salt. All right, science fans, well, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Check out our Instagram and Facebook every day for activities that you can do at home. If you decide to build a water-powered rocket, tag us on Instagram or Facebook with #SmoAtHome.